everywhere we see water, we see life. In the ocean, we have no idea what is going on the seafloor. When we lost a probe the size of a golf cart on Mars, we could find the crash site within 10 days. On Earth, 10 years ago, we lost a jumbo jet with hundreds of souls on board, and we still have yet to find this on the seafloor. We do not have any data on how to quantify how the system is changing through time because we are so data poor. Technology is giving us a lens to see life in its entirety in that environment. The main challenge with what I'm doing, which is to map the seafloor to understand what's in the ocean, is to see through water. I'm trying to map and place objects on the seafloor through a surface that's constantly changing and undulating because air and water bend light differently. And you can see this if you stick a pencil in a glass of water, right? The pencil will look like it's broken, but it's not. It's just light is changing its velocity. That's where the technology comes in. Microprocessors power the inventions I create. They control the logic so all the parts come together
to create an instrument, to make something that can extend human perception of the natural world.
Fluid lensing is a technology that exploits the same waves that cause the problem. Every time a wave passes over an object that has a positive curvature, it acts sort of like a free magnifying glass. And these bright bands of light light up the seafloor like a torch. With these two things exploited, fluid lensing is able to see at really high resolution and at high depth. Every year it's close to 1,000 terabytes of data generated, too much data for humans to process and analyze. So we rely on AI. It's a huge force multiplier in how we can interpret data. And a lot of the times we're just asking the question, is the ocean healthy here? That's one big advance with this technology. We can see how these systems are changing and ultimately how they sustain the natural world.